North Korea test fires four strategic cruise missiles, the latest in a series of provocations that have sent tension soaring in the Korean Peninsula. The missiles were fired from North Hamgyong province and traveled 2,000 kilometers before hitting targets in the Sea of Japan. The tests were timed around joint military drills held by South Korea, Japan, and the U.S., and come on the heels of the firing of three banned missiles in the past week. The death toll from the collapse of an open pit mine in China's Inner Mongolia region rises to six, with dozens still missing, China's Ministry of Emergency says. All-out search efforts are underway, with a top priority being saving lives. A landslide had stalled rescue teams on Thursday. The operator of the mine has been identified as the Inner Mongolia Xinjiang Coal Industry, which was fined for several safety violations in 2022. It has yet to issue a statement on this latest incident. Ukraine is bracing for potential massive Russian strikes on the first anniversary of the invasion. Ramped up security measures are in place across a war-torn nation. Schools have been moved online and people are told to work from home. Meanwhile, the U.S. and its allies are expected to pour in more aid into Ukraine. U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen announced Washington will provide another $10 billion in assistance to Kyiv. She also said the sanctions imposed against Russia are working.
The United States has provided over $46 billion in security, economic, and humanitarian assistance to Ukraine. Our military assistance includes key defensive weapons that Ukraine has asked for, such as the Patriot missile defense system. And our economic assistance is making Ukraine's resistance possible by supporting the home front, funding critical public services, and helping keep the government running. Russia's economy has become increasingly isolated. Estimates indicate that nearly a million Russians may have left the country last year, and this is putting downward pressure on its productive capacity going forward.
The UN General Assembly approves a resolution calling on Russia to end the war. The Philippines, along with 140 other UN members, backed the resolution. Seven countries opposed it, 32 abstained. For a Ukrainian envoy, the resolution is crucial to ending the conflict.
This vote showed the support from the majority of international community to Ukraine. 141 is the great achievement, great result. We are happy that the resolution containing the peace proposal of Ukraine was supported by the majority of the international community. And the main idea here is the withdrawal of the Russian forces from all the sovereign territory of Ukraine in borders of 1991 as a precondition for any talks. This resolution is crucial, actually, because this resolution shows us the way where everybody should be.
China makes a fresh call for a ceasefire and peace talks to end the war in Ukraine. In a 12-point document issued Friday, China calls on all parties to support Russia and Ukraine in resuming direct dialogue as quickly as possible to reach a comprehensive ceasefire. The document did not put forward a timetable for talks nor an offer to host negotiations, but it appears to warn Moscow not to escalate the conflict with nuclear weapons. China also opposing armed attacks on nuclear power plants and calls on all parties to comply with the Convention on Nuclear Safety.